My purpose here this evening is to ask a fundamental question about society and leadership and poverty. Simply stated, if we have the capacity to eradicate poverty, which I believe we do, is any government of any affiliation at the provincial, federal, or municipal level ethical in any meaning of that word if they do not try to do so? And as we know that, depending on the age group and region, between 10 and 15% of our population lives in poverty. We know that this is not about a tiny, statistically insignificant percentage of our fellow citizens. And as we know that the most constant and dependable predictor of early school dropout activity, illiteracy, substance abuse, unemployment, early illness, long hospital stays, family breakup, criminal involvement, premature death, and massively dominant participation as guests of Her Majesty's prisons, the most precise predictor of all of that is poverty. Not dealing with it has broad ethical implications for our entire society. If hospitals are overcrowded and expensive, having the ability to prevent institutional dependence by the poor, by reducing poverty and freeing up resources for other activities like education, is not just a desirable outcome. It is the profoundly ethical thing to do. If poverty ensures that too many students are unable or unprepared to learn, and eradicating poverty increases the intellectual and cognitive opportunities of more and more children, not doing so is surely a prima facie ethical failure. If we know that Canadians who are poor will fare far worse against illness and die substantially younger than those who are not, and we have the means to increase the lifespan of millions by reducing poverty, and we do not, that is a profound ethical failure in government and politics and leadership. I know of no ideology on the right or the left that would make the case for people dying sooner because they were poor. There is no ant and grasshopper fable to justify an ethical framework that accepts without struggle or protest that it is all right for poorer people to live shorter lives, or spend more time in prison, or the courts, or face illiteracy, unemployment, family breakup, or family violence, simply because that's the way it is for the poor. I know of no mainstream religious faith or political creed that would endorse that kind of ethical abdication. Yet that is the precise context 3 to 4 million of our fellow Canadians face right now as we sit here tonight. And so that we do not let the tyranny of small differences blunt the ethical imperative, there is no province, except to its credit, the province of Newfoundland and Labrador, where the level of welfare support for those living beneath either the StatsCan low-income cutoff, which is a relative definition of poverty, comparable definition of poverty, or the less generous market basket measure used by the Fraser Institute, in no Canadian province, except for Newfoundland and Labrador, are families on welfare earning within $10,000 of either one of those basic measures. They are all earning less. In other words, our existing income security programs, except in Newfoundland and Labrador, lifts nobody out of poverty but keeps them trapped in poverty. The safety net is not strong enough to support or lift, but it is strong enough to entangle.